Hi, my name's Mark Downey. I am a program manager on the Visual Studio Production Diagnostics team. Today I'd like to talk to you about IntelliTrace. One of the weaknesses of traditional or live debugging is that it only understands your application's current state, and we have very limited data about past events. To help, you may decide to send log info to the output window. You either have to infer these past events based on your application's current state, or you could recreate these events by rerunning your application over again, but this tends to be really time-consuming. IntelliTrace is a Visual Studio Enterprise feature that expands on the traditional notion of debugging by recording specific events and data. These events might include module load activity or web requests or breakpoints. IntelliTrace then lets you switch between traditional or live debugging and IntelliTrace debugging, allowing you to see what recorded information you might have missed without forcing a restart. Let's see this in action. So I have this ASP.NET application. It is an open source application, and I'm going to use IntelliTrace to help me keep track of very important events as I get deeper and deeper into this debugging and diagnostics session. So I'm going to go ahead and hit F5 and start debugging, and that will rebuild my application. And it will also start the application for me. And it will start running the application and load a bunch of symbols so that I can debug correctly. And before I start recreating the scenario I want to debug, I'm gonna go ahead and set some strategic breakpoints that'll help me with my session here. So I'm gonna go ahead and set a breakpoint here at line 69. I'm interested in the whole action of going to get comments for each of the posts here. So I'm going to hit Control F12, which will take me to the definition of this method. And yeah, I'm really interested in the data I pass to this method. So I'm interested in seeing post ID or comments. And let's take that deeper. I've actually passed those same values onto get comments for. Hit F12, Control F12 on line 437. Again, this is the same data being passed again, so I'm gonna go ahead and pass over this. I don't need a breakpoint here. Control F12 here takes me to some interesting points here. I'm interested in seeing what the data I get back from this method here. That's really interesting on line 1360. And certainly before I return this method back, I'm interested in seeing if I actually even get any entry, any data here. So let's go back to where we started the blog post controller, because we'll be making our way back to the top of the call stack. And I'm certainly very interested in if I have any blog posts and kind of taking a quick review there. So I'm gonna go ahead and recreate the scenario I am debugging, and hopefully that'll mean I hit a breakpoint. Perfect, I'm at my breakpoint. Now, this opportunity, obviously, I can review some data here. And yep, everything seems to be working as I would assume. I can check values and variables that have been passed in at this moment. I can check everything. That's typically what I would expect at a breakpoint. Fantastic. Let's keep going as we hit continue. We hit our next breakpoint, which I strategically put in another method here. And I can check the values being passed. Again, hitting continue. Again, typical of what I'd expect. I can check the date, which is back in February of 2020. Perfect. I can go here and see exactly what information I returned for comments, as I got zero there, and hit continue again. Now this is only just five, I've only hit five breakpoints, but you can imagine sometimes you kind of get several layers deep here. You can decide at this moment, you'll notice right at the top, what's lit up here are a couple of additional icons. Now these are the IntelliTrace step back icons, which essentially say to you, you have the opportunity to go back in time. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit the Alt open brackets, which is the step back shortcut. And you'll see now I've changed slightly, Visual Studio's changed. The top part now is describing that I'm in historical debugging mode. It's saying that there are participating windows that are also historical debugging for me. And it's also giving me the opportunity to return to live debugging at any moment. So if I look at the bottom here, I've got autos in historical debugging. I've got watch in historical debugging, so I can potentially add things there. I've got locals in historical debugging, and my call stack is also historical debugging. So instead of it assuming I am in my controller and in an action, it now sees that the last time I was in this moment, I was actually in internal get comments, which is the top of the call stack, which corresponds currently to the method I'm in. I can take another step back. I can hit Alt open square brackets again and take another step back, and I get to see now the context of the moment I was at this breakpoint. Now notice I've still got this value, because obviously that would have been executed for get date for entry on line 1359. However, after this, these values are all null, because again, that hasn't executed. IntelliTrace has taken these snapshots at this moment in time and associated it correctly with the line I was at when the snapshot was taken. I can keep going up, keep going back to these moments that are important to me. Again, going back to get comments, I can see the values that were passed in at these strategic moments that were important to my debugging session. Now I no longer have to remember all the details about every single moment that led to the error or the problem that I'm investigating. I can use breakpoints not only as pausing moments, but as moments of collecting data that might be helpful to me later down the line. So I can continue to go back in time at this moment, or I can return to my live debugging, which means I'm going to basically continue with what is traditional debugging, live debugging. I'm now back to the yellow highlighted line saying that this is the next line to be executed. What is also really important is that you can use the Diagnostics Tool windows to pick any of these previous breakpoint moments, any of these previous break and step moments that allows me to kind of hydrate some past historical moment. So you can go to the Debug menu item, Windows, and Show Diagnostics Tool. And this opens up the Diagnostics Tool. And if you look at the events, you will see a series of these snapshots that I've taken at each of these breakpoints. And I can choose to activate any one of those by simply selecting and clicking activate. So I can go back to a specific historical moment in time that I know that's important to my current debugging. Today I was able to demonstrate how IntelliTrace is able to help Visual Studio Enterprise users expand on the traditional notion of debugging. IntelliTrace Step Back can save you time when you want to see the previous application state, but want to forego the dozens of restarts necessary to get your app back into the desired state. Thanks for joining today.